Long, long ago, when the universe was young, Grandmother Moon was covered with ice. She had a frost body, sluggish and dense, smoothing over the craters, the scars seen today. This icy moon sea longingly looked onto the clouded blue planet spinning below. Our Earth was warmer then. It had youthful energy, flushed with hot lava, erupting like pimples. Over millennia, Moon Sea watched, growing jealous of the Earth's oceans. Those loving waves, the water hugged the one continent, kissed her rocky edges. Moon Sea planned a closer look, rubbed to the dark side, leaned on her orbit. Though Grandmother was a tired old rock, she still cared for being held. She loved Moon Sea. And slowly the satellite shifted, making an ellipse, passing closer to Earth, helping Moon Sea to observe. When under cover of an eclipse, Moon Sea reached out, gave a wave, called the Earth's oceans. They waved back, but when they touched, the cold Moon Sea made blue Earth freeze. That first ice age changed everything. Frozen in first winter, the continent split. Moon Sea was left, too salty to join, hugging across hard oceans, consoling the seven pieces. Those continents cried, tears that rose the water, spread over them, smothered their peaks. In places, Moon Sea froze too, hiding out of sunlight. Other spots she sank, draining into volcanoes. If you look carefully, you can observe Moon Sea, frozen so the moon can't find her, making puddles under rocks. Even now, Grandmother Moon looks some nights when she misses the sea. She peers over the blue planet, asks the young oceans for help. Those nights the salt water rises, she tugs at the continents, shakes awake volcanoes, tries to reveal the Moon Sea. And some nights, if you look at the partly lit moon, you can see the old seabeds among the craters. Thanks.